and over the years, some of those get beat up, broken, whatever. And then they get mixed and matched with the school ones, and they couldn't decide who's whose. And the wooden tables, those all came out of the town hall too. Now, some of them, all these screws or something, to repair some of them, nobody wants to use them. But we do use them when we have elections and stuff like that, people want to display their wares and stuff.
You also use them to count ballots and stuff too.
Yeah, yeah. Because we don't have enough of the other tables. But as far as that stuff, that's really all you need is tables and chairs and stuff like that. And the biggest part of the problem, nobody tells anybody when something gets trashed. So all of a sudden you short change, where's this, where's that now?
Okay.
Probably ought to have an inventory anyway.
Yeah.
Thanks, Fred. So,
Well, I would make a suggestion to you guys, if you do buy some tables, you can, if you buy them like those white 8-footers, buy 10 at a time, buy a rack for them. So you can wheel them in and out, and maybe do something with the brown ones if people don't use them.
Yeah, well, if this gets established, then we'll have to look at the school to, you know, coordinate that, but yeah, that's the intent anyway.
The big part of the problem too is that they let people in the community use the tables and chairs, and the school was supposed to be in charge of that, that's the way it was all set up, and nobody could get anything out of there unless they went to the secretary of the school and signed off for them. But there was no accountability of signing anything back in. Or putting them back the way everything was supposed to be, you know? And that's when everything was getting abused.
Not a big fan of lending things out that belong to the town.
No, me either.
Personally, as much as you like to and everything like that, exactly what you're talking about, you know?
Yeah, you know, like say somebody had a home wedding or something, you know? They went to the town, but first of all, they had to go through a school to get it, but sometimes some of the stuff didn't come back.
Exactly.
Okay.
Remove snow classroom I.
About B, you okay with 3.3B?
Well, we're still on page 3 here, last one.
Oh, what are we jumping ahead?
Yeah, you jumped ahead.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm sorry. Well, you got your. This is the one I had. Changes.
Yeah.
I, it says snow, remove snow classroom exit windows for emergency egress.
Yeah.
If you go to 3.1P, which is, they monitor, they gotta notify us. I mean, it just says remove the snow. I mean, if these guys are gonna be monitoring it, they we need to have in here, they're gonna be notifying us. Kind of like the D on the parking lot paint lines and all that kind of stuff.
Well, no, wait a second, hold on. So go back to, well, if we go back to the school's responsibility.
Right, well,
where is it here?
P.
All right, so monitor snow ice.
They're just monitoring it, which is good.
Yeah, and notify.
Notify. Right.
Egress and notify town administrator when snow needs to be removed, and then in our portion.
It says remove the classroom from egress. You know, notification should be made in court. I just, you know, just to make sure that.
So is it upon notification?
Yeah, upon.
Okay.
Yeah, upon notification. All right. Or something of that nature.
Yeah, something like it.
Notification, there you go.
All right, because that ties back to the note. Okay.
Yep. Just sort of just coordination between them.
Yep.
Then of course you get J here. So room trash and recyclables from school community center facilities as needed.
Yeah.
You get that correct. You know, you get that right. J.
Yeah. Well, my recommendation, because we don't know how that's going to resolve itself at the moment, is that we hire the, change it so, because we're not tying it to someone being there 4 times a week, because we don't know if that's going to be the future.
Right.
Not only the immediate future, but down the road, the long
way. We're going to have a truck.
Right. So, so the comment that I'm recommending is we hire a contractor or employee to remove trash or recyclable materials from the DPS. Because that would not tie it to how many times a week, and it's not necessarily going to be a town employee. But it may not always be fun.
And because if the truck craps out and we can't get one soon enough, then.
Yeah, or if we don't do the truck at all.
Yeah.
Don't know. And what if what's future boards don't do it for?
Yep. You can't tie their hands.
Right.
So I'm good with that, so.
You're looking at B?
Then in 3.3 here, we already talked about the community center scoreboard, so.
Yeah, we'll move that, yeah.
That'd be town maintain storage room contents, or storage room located outside of kitchen. Got a school.
I had a question about the location, cause the kitchen door. Those are like in the middle of the room, and I thought the one we were talking about was the one that's to the edge you're looking at the kitchen.
Outside
it's to the far right hand side, right?
Gymnasium door.
So is it really the kitchen door? Or is it, how would you describe that door, Mr. Holmes? You know where the storage room is?
Yes.
What, how would you describe that?
It's outside the gymnasium door.
Is outside the gym door?
There's always been like a storage room door. You're talking to the left of where the dishwasher is?
No.
No.
Down where we keep all the tables.
Yeah, that outside storage where all the tables and chairs and that.
Oh, okay.
There are two doors.
Yeah, there's two doors, one in the kitchen.
Yeah, one comes out of the kitchen, one comes out of the.
The gym.
Right.
Yeah, the gym.
Do they both take you to the same?
It's right there.
Yeah, to that concrete landing.
They both do?
Yes. With an overhead, yeah.
Alright, so.
One's the gym and one's the kitchen.
Alright, so kitchen slash gym?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, got it. I didn't realize they both took you to the same place. Okay. Thank you. I'm gonna give that a list of.
Yeah, I don't know, because we're gonna maintain the room and contents, but we don't have the control of the keys.
Well, we're gonna have keys.
Right.
Just that the school wants to be the ones who dole them out, but they'll work with them to, you know, work whatever that is. So there'll be some control, and they're gonna do not duplicates. Well, don't they have control of it today?
They do, yeah, and that's why things get this.
Maybe, yeah.
Well, are you talking about the outside storage room?
Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
Well, the lock disappeared, and then they put another lock on. That lock is the same lock that has the extension ladder.
Mm-hmm.
And the only one supposed to have the key in there is Woody, myself, and the secretary at the school. And when they let people take tables and chairs, sometimes the door gets left unlocked.
Mm-hmm.
And matter of fact, I bought one lock one time. There was only supposed to be three keys for that. He had one because he was setting up the voting booths and all that stuff. And I had one being the moderator and stuff.
Right.
And then the school had one.
Mm-hmm.
But then it got found out here and there. But the lock that's on there now, there's multiple keys for that. And it's in the janitor's storage closet there near the gym.
Right, because I know when last time we did the elections, they had plywood and other stuff there.
Oh, yeah, that was a project.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a bone of contention, been going on for years.
Yeah. That's why I say, as long as we have some type of, you know, recourse on this, because I don't want it to, you know, be our storage room and everybody else is using it and coming and going.
The way it finally got settled was, Les and I, and I think Woody was involved, when we cleaned that whole place out years ago, and that was a town storage room. Not supposed to be anything with the school in it, because they had the storage buildings outside.
Exactly.
You
know, so if it's a town storage room, the school really doesn't need keys.
Correct.
Kind of thing, but
well, it's in their building, and that's their contention. You know, it's,
yeah.
I mean, I get it for security reasons, safety reasons. No, I know, but
the school is, you know, separate from the community center. They just
the facility is the facility, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I understand.
Yeah.
I can live with that.
Okay, good. Move on. Thank you.
This dispute resolution, I disagree with that.
The what?
This new dispute resolution
clause. Yeah, I know.
No way in hell would I agree to that. Plain and simple. Because you get into a contest between the two parties, next thing you know, you're in court. We don't need to be in court and wasting taxpayer money. If we can't agree to it, then it just goes unresolved until another board or school board get together and can work it out.
Okay.
As far as I'm concerned.
Yep.
I'm not going to waste more money in courts for the town.
I know. I was actually a little shocked to see it.
Yeah.
So,
We can do it amongst ourselves then.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. Other than that, that's my 2 cents.
Okay, well, I have your soft copy of this. So.
Yeah.
If you want the soft copy, you want the hard copy?
I'll take this too. I want your notes.
Absolutely.
Okay. that your junk?
Well, no, this was.
Okay, her junk?
Her junk. Well, I'm going to shorten it.
Yep.
Go, I'm probably gonna get it out of here.
Mine?
Yeah, I'm not sure I'll be there on Monday.
Your junk, let them in.
I'll try.
Oh, yeah, if you can, yeah.
My junk.
We just get to one of my notes for that. I think a lot of people are here for that reason, we had a public hearing last week.
Yeah.
Talked about the town hall roof repair.
Mm-hmm.
And, I think it was left with, thanking the public that they had attended, they would take their comments under advisement, I think a lot of them are here.
Mm-hmm.
Just to see if the board has made any decision, and if this is gonna be something that's.
You haven't talked about it.
Nope, this is the first time we've gotten together since that meeting.
Exactly, so, we haven't had any discussion or debate.
Mm-hmm.
We are missing one, I'm sure he's gonna wanna weigh in on it. We make a decision tonight, and we can end up revisiting and change it next week. So, to me, I think it'd be pointless to take and sit here and hash it all out and then have to rehash it again next week.
Okay.
If I'm incorrect, by all means, let me know.
No, I agree that, the full board should be here for the discussion.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm fine with tabling it till next.
Yeah. I remember that happening when Travis was here, we did stuff and then he came in and was like, and had a whole laundry list of stuff that he wanted to rehash all over again.
Yeah. Next week we get to the phone night.
Yeah.
It's okay though.
Yeah. So we're gonna pay for it. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I would definitely table it.
Yeah, I would just soon put it till the whole board's here.
Okay.
Absolutely. Alrighty, we got general ledgers, we got May and June reconciliations, I signed off on these already, so. I should sign off on it, we'll get them out of the way. While you're signing, you can listen in sometime, right?
Sometimes, yeah.
Okay. Since Fred's here, for your benefit, Fred, the Goffstown Board of Selectmen voted on the 2nd of November to share 50-50 the cost to replace the two bounds between Goffstown and Dunbarton. We signed the contract, hmm?
Good job.
Yes. So we've signed the contract, right?
Oh, yeah. I think it's flying.
Yeah, I thought we signed one already. Oh, that was for Kelsey Road turnaround.
Correct.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So.
Is this for the, this is for the surveyor, is that
for the surveyor to dig and replace the bounds from Bartlett and Associates for. Task one, where are we? $1,660 plus cost, reimbursable costs on behalf of the town. And then on the other task, the other bound would be $1,020 plus reimbursable cost. And the, granite bounds would be $217 as needed. So, I'll make a motion that we sign the contract with Richard Bartlett Associates as outlined in their quote. The grant total will be split 50-50 with the town of Goffstown for their board vote.
Okay. How does, who will pay that actual bill? Will we pay the bill and then?
I'm gonna ask if the bill is 50% each.
Separate billings?
I'm sure they can do that.
Yeah.
Alright, yeah.
Do they gotta take and have, Goffstown sign off on us too then?
I think that the email says that they made a motion to.
Yeah, Goffstown Board of Selectmen voted on that to share 50, the cost requested in bounds. But I mean, does Goffstown want a contract with Bartlett themselves?
I scanned that contract to her, she brought it to the board, and she made no mention of who needed to sign the contract. I think it was just giving Bartlett the okay to move forward and.
Well, we get the email that says that they're gonna share it, so we can hold them to it, so.
Alright, yeah.
But I would agree, you know, if we can get them to bill us 50 and bill them 50.
Yep.
And that'd be great, so that way we're not holding them funds and such.
Right.
So, that's the motion.
Okay, I'll second it.
Any discussion?
Just tab it.
Sounds good to me. Alright, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, alright. Fred, do you wanna be the, the coordination with this, where it's kind of right up your alley on the preambulation?
Or?
They're gonna go out and do this stuff, I mean, as a point of contact for them, you know, with you and Lee, potentially.
I'll scan that for them tomorrow.
Oh, because if they have questions or something like that, where you've done it for so long and you've got all the records in your book.
Yeah, that's good.
Appreciate it, thank you. Four.
from November 2015. Invoice address would be 1011 School Street, right? O-3-0-4-6, telephone number is 774-3545. Alright, you keep this together. There you are, ma'am. Thank you. This is all part of that same thing, it's, we have a copy of the perambulation between where, I've read it, it's good. We also have the contracts for the police, since the chief is here. We haven't heard back from town attorney, correct?
No.
Chief, contracts here, I don't know if you have been brought to speak on it?
Just, no, I wasn't here last week.
I know you weren't here last week, I didn't know if you had talked to anybody, huh? We had an issue with the, overall it looked pretty good, but on the end of it here, last page here is 5B, says during the contract period, the lessor or the lessee may terminate this agreement with or without cause upon 30 days written notice to the other party sent by certified mail. We felt that 30 days was a lot of problems.
That's short.
Very short.
Yeah.
Too short. I mean, 30 days, you know, let's say, oh, by the way, we're not gonna house you here for dispatch, we gotta take and pick up stakes and find someone else that's gonna do it within 30 days, it probably won't happen. You know, so we're looking at a longer, term there, or maybe 30 days notice with, you know, maybe 60, 90, 120 days of, you know, continuation until then, you know, some type of language of that nature. And we also asked them to send to the town attorney to take and weigh in on that kind of stuff too, because it was just, you know, a lot of problems that we could just foresee if we only had 30 days notice. Otherwise that, we were okay with it, so.
No, that was the only issue we had last week, we talked about that.
Otherwise that would be willing to sign.
Yep.
If I reach out to them and they wanna go with a longer term, 120 days or 90 days?
I would start with 120, and then I can always negotiate back to 90 or something like that, you know.
Okay.
That's for all.
Cause, you know, it's like anything else, they say 30, you say 90, you're gonna end up with 60, you know, if you start with 120, you might end up with 90, which would be better for us.
Or 30.
Or you, yeah, hopefully not 30. But, you know.
I'll contact them and let them know what the concerns are.
Yeah.
We may just be able to work that out.
I would hope so, but.
I suspect that.
But like any contract, we wanna have the town attorney weigh in on it, but I guess then it's on vacation or something.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not sure when, I don't think I got it out till this week, so.
Well, we can always bring this with us tomorrow, maybe they can take a glance at while we're talking to them about Kelsey Road, kill two birds with one stone.
Or I can scan it to them, and they'll have the answer for us when we get there.
Yep.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Still on schedule?
Hmm?
Kelsey Road, still on schedule?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
1 o'clock?
1 o'clock. Rain or shine.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be beautiful tomorrow.
Must be another beautiful day.
Yeah.
We'll take it.
Looking forward to a walk.
Well, we are the kids.
Yeah.
Well, it's muzzleloader season, so wear your orange.
Yeah, be noisy.
Or it does bring a muzzleloader with you.
That'll bring your gun with you, yeah.
That's the New Hampshire way.
Absolutely. Get that right.
Yeah, I don't know if we've been a public meeting bringing a rifle, I don't know how that would go over.
Come on.
I can see a pocket monitor now.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, so you got that.
Yeah.
I think that's it, except for this insurance thing that, you know, you wanna talk about, so.
Yeah, that, what you have there is a, the board had asked me to give some information to Aflac regarding supplemental insurance and or possibly a different insurance plan. I've not heard back from them since sending the required information that they asked for. In the meantime, this company here, which is called Combined Insurance, has been in my office weekly asking if town would be interested in going with them. They do not offer the insurance package, but this is the supplemental insurance that started the Aflac, the inquiry with them. And the difference between this company and Aflac is that they deal directly with the employee. It would not have to be a payroll deduction, it would be a lot, they bill and talk to the individual and they bill them.
So less work for the town.
Absolutely, yeah, and
Payroll deduction, it's not, once you get it established, it's.
True, but then you have the, you have to kind of check, you have to make sure that the employees, you know, they're working and or working enough to cover the expense. Doesn't interfere with any turnover for the system and maintaining the employees in the system.
Oh, no, I understand that. Do we wanna entertain them, have them come in and see us, or?
Well, with your permission, I have the state deferred compensation plan scheduled for the 18th on Wednesday, two meetings. And I've checked with him, he said he usually goes through, I think his name's Dennis from the state, usually goes through discussion with his presentation, and he said it wouldn't be a problem if he piggybacked and.
That meeting on the 18th isn't for the board, right?
It's all employees.
All right, yeah, I understand, I didn't have that listed.
I mean, if you want to be here and.
Yeah, if you want to.
Do you defer it off?
Yeah, work.
So, one thing is, I always suggest you do, just as a full disclosure, is maybe reach out to Aflac and say, you know, that way.
Oh, my life, fire them to them.
Yeah, or offer them to say, hey, you know, this is what's going on, these folks are gonna be here, you're welcome to be here. And everybody can do their dog and pony show at the same time.
Okay.
If they have questions or they want to sit there and compare apples to oranges.
Nothing like apples and competitors.
Absolutely. But I think it might be a better product for the employees.
Yep.
That way they can decide themselves.
Ladders, chairs, and tables, yeah.
If they don't want to come, then well, as soon as they lose.
Yep.
I don't know if I'm gonna come up if, you know, get the information. But it would be nice to have an information packet for us so we can, you know, have an idea of what's going on. So we're still in the loop.
Well, we'll just grab one of the employee packets.
Anything else for the good of the town?
I just want to give you a heads up. I've been, Ken Kerber and John Stevens has been in touch with me. They will be coming to the November 19th Board of Selectmen's meeting, so.
19th November?
Yep. And they will be here to answer any questions the board might have regarding that community profile report, so you might wanna.
Pull up on it, huh?
Yeah. I think I gave it to electronic.
Yeah, I got it.
It's my other board.
You can have it in print.
I get my other book.
Okay, that's all I know. My other subject was regarding the Century Roof, but because it's been tabled, we'll wait until next week.
Yeah, no, I can just say, I think it'd be.
Yep.
It's a topic I think it'd be best to have all three of us here, so that way everybody can weigh in and get their vote. Nothing else? Kelsey Road tomorrow, 1:00. Then we're going to the town attorney.
Yes.
And so bring all your questions and concerns and such, so we can file. You're gonna bring the road file? You know, the file of everything?
Yep, I have everything already.
Okay, beautiful.
Well, you're not going on the sidewalk.
I might.
You might?
I have my boots, yeah.
Okay.
If you fall down, break the other wrist. I can
pick you up if you want.
I'll be riding my motorcycle, I'm sorry.
That's fine, but I could pick you up.
I'll park my car on Montalona Road.
You will?
At my land.
Oh, alright.
That way
I can
backtrack here.
Alright.
Whatever works, give me a call in the morning.
Alright, we'll talk. You and I are meeting cemetery.
Cemetery.
But you're gonna call me in a minute.
Yes.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah, all we right. Got a map to help for the Dennis.
Yeah.
Do I have to go to the order?
I have lots of things.
Okay, fire away. I'm brain dead.
It's okay. Just brain cramp. That's okay. I've been looking at websites for the town.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
And I think I forwarded you guys one. This company's called VTS, or Virtual Town School. And they do an awful lot of our local schools. I'm sorry, our local towns, but most recently added to their client list is Lincoln, New Hampshire, Springfield, Temple, Salem, Merrimack, and Auburn. So I took a look at those because those were built on their newer platform. And they're really pretty cool, so if anybody has time to go look at those towns. And,
which ones?
Lincoln.
Thank you.
Springfield. It's on, if you get the package, it's on page 2.
Oh. Lincoln, Springfield, Temple, Salem.
Yeah.
Okay. Got you.
So it's Lincoln, Springfield, Temple, Salem, Merrimack, and Auburn. So I've been on those because those are on their newer platform. They've been around for a while, so not everybody's migrated over to this new platform, but that's the most current. The web page is very friendly. You can put alerts on it so that if the resident has set it up to receive alerts, there's a drop-down list, and you pick the ones, the different departments you want to get them from. So if something comes up on the website, it sends out a mail blast. So it's kind of a nice communication tool, which is one of the things we heard at the lovely Dunbarton thing here.
Profile,
thank you. That people wanted more communication, and a couple of the technology meetings, there was a whole band of people that came in and wanted social media and a whole bunch of other things that the town doesn't offer currently. So through this webpage, you can do some of those things, but I would just suggest you go in there, poke around, and take a look at it. to get started with these folks, they have a $5,000 one-time startup fee. That you can spread over around the 3-year period. Their annual cost is $1,750, and they can see a whole list of things. What I would like to do is invite them in to do a dog and pony show. Mm-hmm. And I would suggest that we reach out when we do that to department heads, the school board. Because you can link, for example, like the fire department has their own website, the police does. Through this website, there's a click, takes you right to their web pages. So it's a one-stop shop kind
of
thing.
Would it take it to their individual current web page, or would it take it to a new web page?
They can have a new web page, but if they choose to keep their current one, I forget which one of these I went to, because I've been to so many lately. Mm-hmm. I think it might have been Auburn, but their police fire department has its own web page, and it took me right to that web page, and it wasn't owned by these folks, it was another party. So I know that it'll do that kind of linking. It had all kinds of things on it. It's very easy to navigate. Like I said, it has email notifications, Twitter, Facebook, blogging, embedded videos. There's a smartphone version that comes with the package. You can share the page. If you need a service request, you can do that. It was really... my experience with using COTS type things off the shelf, this one here looked really user friendly.
It'd be cool to send this out to the IT committee and let them play with it too.
Yep, I haven't done that, but I could certainly do that and invite them to go browse around these websites.
I could hear what they have to say.
Yep. The guy that I talked to, Bill Letsky, he's out of Boxborough, Mass. He offered to, come up and do a presentation.
Boxborough, what else? Boxborough?
Chief, where's Boxborough?
Boxborough is 495 North by Chelmsford.
Oh, so it's not that far away then. Okay. I've heard of that, I just couldn't place it.
So, it's across the border,
The People's Republic of Massachusetts.
I've heard that there is another state there.
Yeah, it's a state already.
Yeah. So, if we pick a date, I will, and I would suggest we do it in December, maybe, because November is pretty tight at the moment.
And we're going to lose a day with Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving. So, do we want to pick a couple of dates that I can try to do?
You probably want to do it this year if you decide you want to put it in the budget for next year.
Well, that's what I'm thinking, Well, if that's the case, if we decide to go that way. 3/10/17. Those are the three choices you have.
I'd rather do it sooner than later because we're going to be digging into the budget.
Right. So the 3rd?
Yeah. It's going to start eating up a lot of our time, so sooner the better.
Okay, let me. December 3rd. Alright, I'll see what I can do. In the meantime, I would invite you to go to their website and also go to some of these other towns, because I think you'll like what you see.
Absolutely.
They have online training, go live prep. That all comes as part of that initial setup fee. They'll take your current web stuff and migrate it over.
Well, we have two. We have archived one and we have the current one. So.
Yeah, and that's kind of where you start, you know, with them, and then you build from there. So then that annual fee is for licensing and content management, secure hosting.
So it'll be on their web. It'll be on their server.
On their hosting server. Yep. Unlimited support for two primary contact editors, unlimited number of contact editors, I don't quite understand what that means. And then
contact editors would be people add minutes or something like that.
Yeah, we have unlimited support, but for two, but then unlimited number of content editors, so I'm not sure how that support thing works with the...
They probably want it to be
To me, it's like two super users, I'm thinking.
Yeah.
And then everybody else. Yeah, you have two super users. Yeah.
Right. Content editors would be like a chair of a committee that, you know, like John has the zoning one, may want to put something up on the zoning board.
Right.
Know, website. Yeah. Just using that as an example, John.
Yep. So anyway, so that's a skinny on that. We talk about the school agreements.
Yeah. Do we want to send this to Jim to have him take a look at it?
I don't know what it was. Yeah, Jim Misha?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can do that.
Just
when I send it to the technology team, I'll do that. I know there was something else I had.
Yeah.
Did you have a question about that?
Nope.
Ted and I went to the transfer station
a week ago, Monday. Yeah.
Or last Monday, I don't even forget.
I had a brain cramp.
Yeah, I know, that's all right.
I've seen the lights anyways.
We went there to look at the lighting, because we're talking about lighting for this parking lot. And the lighting there was more than adequate. The only concern I had is that if I were a neighbor here, I don't know if those things are shielded at all. I know John talks about, you know, being able to focus the beam and all that. But the bottom line is, if you're sitting somewhere and your eye is catching that lamp, it's going to be bright. Yeah, the light may not be stray light all over the place, but it's a bright light. It's like looking at the sun. So I'm thinking, you know, these folks who live along here, I know we got to do something for safety reasons, we need to do it, but I don't know if that's the answer.
Full of shade, I mean, it'd be no different than a street light.
Yeah, it wouldn't be, but it doesn't exist today.
No,
and people are going to, you know, they're going to have, they may have an objection to it if that situation exists. If it doesn't, then, you know, no problem, but, and I know we talked about a 20-foot pole.
Yep.
You know, and John says he can angle those things to some degree. So if that pole, for example, is here, and light is angled that way, then maybe it's less of an issue. I don't know. But that was kind of our, you know, what we observed. These aren't exactly the lights at the transfer station, not exactly the lights that we're talking about here, but they're similar. And we went there mostly just to kind of get a feel for... you know, how much light you do get. You get a lot. I was pretty surprised.
These are good.
It would, and it would light this little narrow parking lot adequately, because that lit from the, we shut off the lights individually, but it lit all the way to that back tree line. There was plenty of light.
I don't doubt it.
So I think going that way is not a bad idea. It's just, I think the neighbors over here may have a concern if they suddenly have a bright light that they don't have today. For what it's worth.
Yeah.
But I still think we should go forward, and I think one lamp, maybe two, might be adequate.
Pole, right?
One pole here, and maybe one on this end of the building, possibly.
On a pole, or just a...
I think on a pole is what we talked about with John.
Yeah, I thought we were going to do one over each overhang, and then the pole, right?
Yeah, that would, you know, whatever we do on this end to get lighting, yeah, if it's on the building or whatever, but yeah. But that type of lighting, I think, would certainly work, and I think two would be more than enough.
Sure.
I think, and I don't know if Ted feels the same way. We really talked about it, but you can ask him.
Well, then we'll have to have that debate and go forth.
Yep.
All right.
So that was
appreciate that.
Kind of the last thing.
All right. You good at the table?
Yep.
All right. I'm going to go around the horn here. Mr. Moderator, you got anything for the good
order?
Yeah,
two things, like you just brought up the lights. A question I would have is that you said you could angle the lights down or something.
Yeah, John said that the heads move a little, I don't know how much, cause I've never seen the windshield.
What about people driving in, is it gonna be shining in the windshield or?
They're gonna be motion detected, so they're not gonna be on all the time.
No, I'm saying people driving.
Well, they're gonna be 20 feet up in the air.
Be like any other light, it's gonna be coming down.
I don't think there'd be any different than a street lamp.
Oh, okay, I thought there'd be like a floodlight that does down in the transfer station.
Well, they are that type of light, but not exactly like those. And they'd be hanging, they'd be aiming downward with old ones that the transfer are kinda out and up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The other thing was, I happened to notice when the meeting was going on, we have the flag stand here now, what's the status of the flag and the pole that the 250th committee bought for the town?
Trying to put it together.
They have to be put together?
That piece?
Yeah.
Got wedged, remember you tried to fix it?
Yeah, yeah.
I just haven't had time to.
Okay.
To look at it.
I happened to see the stand and I said, I wonder where it was.
Front on that light, we also asked.
Yeah, the ferrule.
We also asked John if he could find out from the contractor, if there was an installation somewhere that we could go see.
Yeah.
But we haven't heard back from John, so I don't know.
Years ago, we used to have a, I guess there were like a mercury vapor light on in front of each door. They pretty well lit up the parking lot.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's the cost of operation is what we're trying to, kind of paying attention to. But yeah, we asked John to find out if there was an installation somewhere. But like I said, I haven't heard from John, so I don't know if he followed.
I mean, if you go to some parking lots, the lights are so bright, you know, like that.
Yeah, these are, what do they call them, nighttime approved or skylight approved, whatever it is. So they're not supposed to be a lot of random light from them anyway. Not an expert in lights.
I'm just thinking people driving in and all of a sudden see something.
Yeah, I'm all about incandescent lighting.
Yeah.
You come into the 21st century here, it's LED now.
I got rid of all of them. They went to the transfer.
I still use my.
I took them all out, I got rid of them all. Incandescent light effect, I hoarded them when they threatened to take them off the market. I've got enough to last till the end of time. I'll sell you some if you need.
I'd rather have an LED any day.
Incandescent lighting.
Those squirrely ones don't last long either. That's what he lasts.
Well, now the compact for us.
Boxes and boxes. That's the situation.
Yeah, I've got hundreds of them today.
Actually, I just replaced two compact fluorescent, and they've been in place, I want to say, probably a good 3-4 years now. They finally blew it. That's it. John,
there's
no comments on it. Chief?
Yeah, I just wanted to know, since I haven't talked to you guys since last week, what your thoughts were about the radio situation. Do I have the green light to get going?
I had a couple of questions, but I don't know if that's something you want to do in public, though. That's the only thing.
We can do it non-public afterwards.
Yeah, if you got a few minutes.
Sure.
Okay.
Yep. But to answer your question, yes.
I'm anxious to get going.
I would have thought that we would have had some communication going back and forth, but I mean,
been pretty hectic.
I understand.
Yep.
Yeah, I was out all week.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm good with it, but I do have some questions.
Right. What do you, anything else to the transfer station?
I do as a taxpayer, but not as a transfer station.
You're the last of the town boards or employees, so go right ahead. You can start off as the taxpayer side.
Okay, as a taxpayer side, I have concern on the couple policies that the town has put in place that others made to do and the board doesn't seem to follow it. I got a right to know request regarding these doors. You asked me a couple weeks ago when I got it if the information was there that I wanted.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't there because I read it. Yeah. I got it that day and you asked me that night and I didn't really have time to read it. My concern is this. Your policy says that you get a phone request, phone quotes, and if it's over a certain dollar amount, you have to actually get a price for written prices.
Mm-hmm.
These doors are $4,800.
Yep.
There's no phone quote for them. So
I'm not sure
why we're not following the policy up here. In my request, they'd asked, we had worked under these doors prior to new doors put in. There's no information. I got no information on that.
I read that and I don't
It didn't say anything about that. Everything I saw was listed out for these doors, but not for previous fixing of these doors.
I don't understand that. They would have to pull it over. They would have
and,
to pull it
because right, and the other question is, I mean, you pay $4,800 for these doors. They still not do not close.
They do.
They don't. I was in here, I've been in here several times. That door down at that office does not close. It'll come open, it'll shut, and it'll stay open about that far. I looked at it. I've seen it. This one up here does the same thing. I check it every time I come in here, I check it. I'm just a little, it irks me inside that, you know, one, it was a selectman's buddy that got it. Without even, you know, it'd be one thing that would to clear up the unethic part of it, is if there had been three phone quotes and there's no questions. Yep, this guy was low, no problem, but no phone quotes. And you give it to a selectman's buddy. It just, it doesn't look good across the board. But yet then other departments are made on a small little meniscus $300 job to go get three phone quotes. I don't see the fairness in the departments when, and I had no problem following the rules, but as a taxpayer, I don't see how
it's. Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
Where are you going to draw the line as a taxpayer or a department head? Because you're mixing.
Okay, as a taxpayer, I want to know why the selectmen aren't following their own policy they put into play.
Actually, we did, because if you read the policy, it has in there where we deem it as a necessity emergency situation. We can just get it done. The doors, it was a security issue, falling apart, and we just wanted to get them done and get it secured, the building secured.
My concern is a couple of weeks prior to that, they were in here three times fixing those doors before you replaced them. So we didn't have time to get three phone quotes on it. I'm just asking because this, it really irks me. This irks me to no end.
We couldn't lock the door. The only door that allowed us to lock this building and secure it is the one near my office. And that was a door that we could not open. The key mechanism had failed. And it was an emergency situation. It was a Friday night. I prayed we didn't break the key in the door because I would be breaking a window to get in. Because all the other doors would have been locked. And at that same token, the selectman authorized me to key alike all the doors so that it would be eliminate that problem. Whereas before, we had the key wrenched and pushed the door lock open for other doors except for the one.
Oh, it still doesn't make it right. I mean, there's plenty of contractors in this town other than a selectman's buddy.
That's not my buddy, so.
No, I didn't say, I'm not naming any names. I just said a selectman's buddy.
It's an acquaintance.
I just.
Like all of you are acquaintances.
Yeah, I just said a taxpayer. I'm not happy with the way this goes down. I'm not happy at all.
Duly noted.
Okay. Can I ask a question on the same line?
Sure.
Years ago, when they had the regular key for these doors, the fire department had a knock box, a key in case we had to get in for emergency use. Mm-hmm. How would they get in now with just
these same thing? Buttons? There's a key
with
in that
key.
Door.
Mm-hmm. A key will open these doors.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then every the select individuals like John have a pass key code to get in.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Paul.
Yeah. I guess on the same note that Woody was talking about. So, it was an emergency, I understand. So what made the town call that particular contractor versus the fellow who was working at the fire department, who I hear did a fantastic job?
I didn't answer that, because I didn't make
the call. But it does sound kind of funky the way he said it then, you know? I mean, this. I hear this, I haven't gone to the open house yet. When is it, next week?
16th.
18th.
18th? No. Oh, change it.
No, the 12th.
16th.
Oh, sorry, the 16th, right.
Yeah, okay, you're right.
Anyways,
you're
so.
Right. Right. You're more than me.
So I plan on going there, see? So, but I heard a lot of good about this, and I'm thinking, so here's a contractor here in town that just finished a nice job. You'd think you could have called him and said, hey, we got an emergency.
I'll take the blame for that. I'm the administrator, and I made the call. It was an emergency situation. I was concerned that a key was going to bust off in the lock on a Friday afternoon, and I pled with I asked the cleaning lady to be careful with it. We put as much WD-40 in there.
Kind of like what you said, though, you know.
And it was a certain.
Doesn't look good.
I made the call, and it was my choice. Someone that I could get a hold of at that moment. If I'd have thought of somebody else that I knew of.
Just keep that guy in mind.
I will, for the future, yeah.
I mean, just to say, you know.
Yeah.
Just to add to that list, Tim Tarigny would be interested in knowing, and he's been living in town for a long time.
Okay, I'll add those to my call list.
You have a call list, sorry?
We do.
I don't, I do now.
Okay.
So, on another point, so you're gonna discuss the roof next week, I guess, right?
That's correct.
Can we speak to that next week, or should I just talk now? I mean, it's gonna be, I know you already had the public hearing, I understand that, I was here. But in the meantime, you get to think a little more, and, you know, are we gonna get to speak, or are we gonna just have to listen and see what happens?
What's the will of the board?
Well, I'm in favor of all the information we can possibly have.
I was leaning that way myself, but,
So I don't have to speak to it tonight, I can do, wait.
Well, you can do it tonight, I'd like to have it now.
Yeah, I mean, if you could do it now, it'd be nice, or if you had questions.
Well, it's not information, it's just, I guess there's a little bit, but, number one, I am in favor of putting it back out to bid, only because it wasn't really much presented to us at all. I mean, I think it was pretty poorly presented. And the number two was what, Brian, you said that you were worried that it was gonna leak. The roof was gonna leak this winter, but a few meetings back, you said during the walkthrough that the contractor looked at it and he said it should be fine till next spring. It wouldn't be a problem. If you look back in the minutes, I can remember hearing that myself. So that kind of like threw me. I was like, wait a minute, what's really, you know, what's what?
I know that's been one of our concerns about, you know, potentially leaking, because the more...
Right, but you're the one who yourself said that the contractor looked at it and said...
We had Ralph look at it.
Well, that was ways back.
Yeah. That recently, I don't know about the contractor
It was after I got back from up my vacation in Canada, so it was after the walkthrough. I wasn't here for that period. I heard about the walkthrough after, and it was during
I wasn't there for the walkthrough. Ted was, so...
Well, somebody, I believe it was you, said the contractor said it would be fine through the winter, so I just don't understand why all of a sudden worry about
it. I don't recall saying it, but that's okay. Fine. Okay, all right. Argue.
So somebody said it anyway.
Yeah, it could be.
You know? So that kind of like threw me last week. I was like wondering about that. So my point is, if we can speak to it a little bit while you're discussing it, because, I mean, this... Mm-hmm. Pretty big project here, you know. You had a lot of people speaking to it last week, and there's a lot of information out there. Jeff Trexler really made a lot of good points, you know. So.
Yes, indeed. I'm fine with, you know,
some people might not have been able to make the public hearing, you know, and
I think
might be here.
The input's important.
Yeah.
You know, can I ask a question?
Sure.
Only because he brought up a few things, and you know, they did a walkthrough from on the ground. Mm-hmm. Do you think it might have been prudent to have the roofer look at the roofing structure from the inside? I'm going to tell you, I just did a little demo over at the library and did some framing and re-nailed the vertical 2x4s that have come separate from the beam. So I don't know what that looks like up above.
Yeah, they were floating, right?
They were floating. The 2x4s were floating.
Really?
And that's the wall structure. So it might be prudent to have that looked at from the inside so you know what the cost is, mm-hmm. in case you can't get volunteers.
Mm-hmm. Is that inside wall you're talking about floating, or the outside wall?
Outside.
The wall facing 13 when I was framing in that stairway. Mm-hmm. And I was using the nail gun and looking at the 2x4s moving because they had come separate from the beam, so I re-nailed them. So I don't know, again, I don't know what, you know, the framing for the roofing, if there's any structural, I know it has to be beefed up, according to the engineer, but you don't even know if it's separate. You're looking up at it, and from the level you're looking at, it may look perfect. When you get up on a scaffolding and you look at it, it might be completely different. So, you know, to invest in a roof and then have it collapse and go from square one again because we didn't do diligent and look at it from the inside and see what's supporting it. I mean, I don't care what you guys use for material in the side room, but at least it should be support, you know, be able to support the weight.
Yeah, we already lost the ceiling. Right? Already lost the ceiling in here with Mert, you know. Mert's gone, I'm not picking on him.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, we already lost the ceiling because somebody didn't look ahead, you know, see what we're
doing. Well, that's because they blew insulation up on the tin ceiling.
Right, yeah. Right. That's my point. You see, without checking into this, place, you know. So. All right, and that's what I feel.
Darling?
Oh, sure.
She was asleep in the car.
Right?
She was asleep in the car.
Yeah. I could. Well, she was so small. She sits so low, like Fred was blocking her. I couldn't see her half the time anyway. So. All right. That's Linda, you have anything to add for the good work here?
Don't have anything new, but I've been thinking about what Tom said about some residents and the notice that I put out. They should come and talk to me. I'd be more than happy to talk to anybody who has a concern. So certainly could recommend that.
It's been done. Can't force them in the door, though.
No, certainly can't, but I can't. If they don't come to me, I'm not going to deal with hearsay.
Yep.
So, but anyway, that was my suggestion. Other than that, nothing else.
There you go. Hearing nothing else, then. Make a motion to go into non-public session. RSA 99.